afternoon baseball here on the show. Today we've got a good matchup in store between the Los Angeles Angels of Anaheim and the Philadelphia Phillies. Stay tuned for Phillies baseball. Phillies, as they begin play here today, they've been hot of late, winners in four straight.
Yeah, Matty, you got to applaud this team. They've scratched and clawed their way back to 500, and they're playing good fundamental baseball right now. They got some pitchers who can execute, and they got some guys who can drive the ball out of the ballpark. This should get interesting for this team as the summer progresses.
3-0 now. It's hot, but not too hot this afternoon, and even 90 degrees here at first pitch. Hit in the air down the right field line and foul. Down the first baseline, but this will wind up foul as he runs the count full now. Spoils another one. And this is exactly what you're looking for out of your leadoff hitter.
Not surprised he's late on a heater right there. Just saw an off-speed pitch. Wanted to stay back a little bit too long.
Hit out towards second. And a base hit, so the leadoff man is on to begin the inning.
I know in today's game everybody's trying to go yard, but can you look at having a better at bat as a leadoff hitter? You take a full count, you make the pitcher work, and then you come through with a knock. Great start.
Next steal. Ryan Goodman. That's a strike to throw down. It's going to be far too late. That's a stolen base.
Well, I think he's making it pretty obvious why he's batting leadoff, isn't he? Works his way on base to start the game, and then does even better by swiping second to put himself into scoring position. He's trying to make an impact from the get-go in this one.
The 0-1 on its way. Swing and a miss on the slider, and he's quickly behind, nothing and two. Time for a look at our umpires in this one. Behind the plate is Earl Hendricks.
Hey, D-Roll, Earl Hendricks, he's not a guy that gets a lot of complaints by either players or pitchers. He's a pretty good umpire.
Yeah, Dan, Earl's got a great track record in his sport. He's pretty consistent, and overall, he's been a fair umpire.
A ball and two strikes now. And this one's in the dirt, but it won't skip away far enough for the runner to advance. Maben stands at second with no outs. And he tried to hold up that time. We'll get an appeal down to third, and no swing. It's ball three. And awfully close there on 3-2, but take your base, says Earl Hendricks. It's ball four.
Two ways to look at this walk. If you're the hitting coach, you say, that's a great AB. Down 0-2, and you work the walk. But if you're a pitcher like me, that's just a case of letting a guy off the hook, and that can really frustrate you.
And that'll bring Mike Trout to the dish. He drove in one of their two runs in last night's ball game. First offering on its way. Right side, but it's going to be a foul ball. That's taken. Now it's 0-2. first and second here with nobody out. Did a good job to shorten up and protect the plate, and he'll have another shot at it here. Swing and a miss as he ran the fastball right by him for the first down.
Talk about blowing it by a guy. Geez, I mean, that fastball was way behind him when the swing came through the zone. I have to think he was looking for something off speed, and he just couldn't pull the trigger on that fastball.
And digging in next will be Anthony Rendon, as he'll watch a slider that runs out of the strike zone away for ball one. He'll come in here at 263, 10 home runs, 53 RBIs. He's ready. Here's the 1-0.
1-1.
Line drive to left, but pretty much right at the left fielder as he takes it in for the second out. So now to the plate, Didi Gregorius. His lifetime line against Velasquez. He's hitting .429. He also has one home run. Trying to hang a zero. Here's the pitch. And this is on the outside corner for strike one. Comes set, the 0-1. Hit sharply on the ground. Forsythe has it, and the two-out threat will not come to pass as the inning is over. Angels strand a couple. So now the Phillies offense will see what they can do. No score. Jaime Barilla, a Panamanian right-hander, will get the nod here. What do we need to know here, Danny?
One of the things that jumps out if you look at that stat sheet, a very high whip coming into this start. One of the things he's going to have to do a much better job, keep traffic off the bases, keep the walks down, try to limit the amount of hits. He's had a rough go at that so far this year. Let's see if he can turn it around.
Gene Segura standing in. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. Here's the pitch. Ball out to right field. Maben on the run. Won't get to it, and this should put a man in scoring position to start the inning. And he'll pull into second here with nobody out.
There's no question he's been struggling competitively, trying to do anything to get himself in. So he's got to be pretty good after that help. Not to take anything away from him, but I think I could have probably hit that pitch.
Yeah, that's one of those gift pitches, not the location you were shooting for. Justin Turner, as you check out his righty-lefty splits, no surprise that he hits better against southpaws than he does against right-handers. From the stretch, here's the pitch. And a high strike there, 0-1. These Angels, as they enter play here this afternoon, fellas, they continue to fall on hard times, losing again last time out, and that makes seven losses in their last eight games.
Yeah, man, things haven't gone too well so far in this series, D-Ro. They're looking to avoid the sweep here in this one.
Yeah, they got to get off in the early innings. It's going to be monumental if they can push a few runs across and give this pitcher a chance to relax.
Two pitch. runner at second, nobody out. And another foul ball.
Don't be shocked if this pitcher tries to go a little bit further outside the zone. Three foul balls in a row. He wants to get a swing and a miss on this next pitch.
Bounce to first. Fielded cleanly. And he'll take this to the bag himself for the first out. But it's a productive one as the runner moves up to third.
Batting third. The better fielder. Mark Withenshaw.
Into the box now. Mark Withenshaw. He's got three hits in six tries for the series. Here comes the first pitch. Right taken as that one catches the outer part of the plate. A man at third with one away. And he'll try to take control of the inside part of the plate here as that misses.
You know, pitching isn't always about throwing strikes. Sometimes you just need to make sure your opponent isn't too comfortable up there. And that's just what he did right there. Busted it inside with good hard stuff.
The count now at 2-1. From the stretch.
That missed. That's the ball.
You would think in this situation, maybe with a base open, he'd just pitch around him and put him on first. But not with the guy in the on-deck circle. He's going to attack this hit.
And he looks at ball four now. So he's aboard, and you always have to worry about the threat of the steal when he's on base.
Almost looked semi-intentional there. The bad news is that there are two men on base. The good news is that an inning-ending double play is now in order.
Stepping up to the plate, Bryce Harper. What a season he's having. Entering play, leading the league in two of the three Triple Crown categories.
Yeah, this guy's got the home run and runs batted in thing figured out for the Triple Crown, but he's not in the top five in the batting average if he wants to win the Triple Crown, so he's going to have to make up a lot of ground.
Now a move over to first, and he's back easily. Here's the first pitch to him. Squared that one up just a little late.
You're lucky if you get one pitch a night right down the middle. Cannot be late on that fastball.
Harper behind with an 0-2 count now.
Not much you're going to do with that pitch right there. You have to catch it out front before it even breaks. And even if you do that, it's a tough pitch to keep fair.
Runners are at the corners with one man out. Rolled slowly down the first baseline, but a foul ball, and the count holds it 0-2.
As a pitcher right there, do not be surprised if he throws the same exact pitch. He was lucky to foul that one off.
Lays off that time, and it's 1-2.
I wonder if that call not going his way right there has anything to do with walking the last guy. We all know umpires don't give you much on the corners if you're not throwing strikes consistently.
The 1-2 is belted, and take a look at this. Deep to right center field, and it's gone. Harper, number 33 on the year, and the Phillies open up a 3-0 lead.
That's how the manager drew it up right there. Hold the visiting team scoreless, and then grab a huge home run in the first.
Next to bat will be Rhys Hoskins. As the first pitch to him is in there for a called strike one. He'll start this one at 274. 23 homers and 58 runs batted in. Now the pitch.
Looked like he was cheating a heater right there. A little bit too far out in front. Got to find a way to keep his hands back.
On its way, the 0-2 pitch.
Ball.
Boy, he sped him up in this at-bat. Now it's time for the changeup. This guy's got a good one, and he hasn't thrown it yet in this at-bat.
Three runs already home here. Had to sit back on the changeup, and he did a good job to get the bat on that one. He takes strike three called on the fastball. Couldn't pull the trigger, and there are two away.
This pitching staff has done a really good job against this guy in this series. This is a really good hitter. And it's not easy to make a guy strike out five times in a series up to this point, but that's what they've done to this guy so far.
Here's Jay Bruce now. As he lays off the fastball too low for ball one.
I think this inning could have far-reaching effects in this game. They're really making him work, and unless he dials it in, it's probably going to limit how deep he goes into this game.
A high fastball is in there. Maria has made a name for himself as a starter that simply misses the barrel of the bat. Rarely allows a large number of hits, and he does a pretty good job at keeping the ball in the ballpark when the hitters do make contact. Can't keep the weight back, and he falls behind 1-2. Now here's the pitch.
No,
the classic back foot slider right there with two strikes. Usually gets a ton of swing and misses. Nice layoff right there. Fight for another pitch.
Here now the 2-2. Bases are empty here with two men out. Bouncer to the left side. Throw in time, and the side is retired. But the Phillies use the long ball here, and they get three on this three-run home run. We'll head to the top of the second. It's now 3-0 Philadelphia. Here's Tommy La Stella now. Get a look at his current righty-lefty splits entering play in this one.
Hey, we're still in the early stages in this one. They're only down by a couple of runs, but it's really key for this leadoff guy to try to get on and get a big inning started.
Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. This ball's hit in the air down the right side and out of play. 0-1. Swing and a shot hit down the corner, but this one will bend. Foul. Had plenty of distance though as it landed to the upper deck. Here's the pitch.
1-2.
Well, there's the classic 0-2 wasted fastball, not even close to the zone. We'll see what he throws on the next pitch.
Here he comes on a ball and two strikes. And a big cut at the breaking ball, but he comes up empty, and that's the first out.
Batting, batting.
The first in now, Mark Canna.
Mark Canna.
First offering on its way. Too high that time with the slider to start the at-bat. It's ball one. One out, nobody on. Now Canna smacks one to left. Lots of carry on this one. Back goes Bruce. On the warning track, he makes the catch.
Batting it. The catcher, Christian Vasquez.
So bases are empty here with two gone. From the on-deck circle into the batter's box comes Christian Vasquez. First pitch on its way.
That missed. That's the ball.
Two out, nobody on. One and one count now to Vasquez. Vasquez, former Red Sox. He came here by way of trade earlier this year.
I know he'd tell you he'd like to be playing a little bit better, but I think it's as advertised for this ball club right now. I think the manager isn't getting exactly what they expected.
Him off a bit with a fastball in, but it's 3-1 now. Hitters count all the way. Here it comes. And he misses here for ball four. Already two walks surrendered in his first couple of innings of work.
That's a nice job to work that walk right there. Even if it doesn't lead to anything on the scoreboard this inning, it prevents the pitcher from having to lead off in the next one. Just one of those small things that might go unnoticed, but in the end, make a big difference.
Next to hit will be the pitcher, Jaime Barria. First pitch of the at-bat on its way. This is lined to left, and that'll get by and on through towards the wall. So now they'll have two men in scoring position following the two-out double.
Well, you never want to give up a hit to an opposing pitcher, but when you give one up to an AL pitcher, it's downright annoying. Can't let it get to you, though.
At the plate now, Cameron Maven. He'll look at a breaking ball that misses for ball one. He singled to open up the ball game. Just off the outside that time, laid off for a ball. Runners at second and third with two gone. Two balls and a strike to the Angels leadoff hitter. Here's a big swing and a miss on the fastball. 2-2.
With the way this guy's throwing on the mound, you cannot be chasing. You have to set your sights a little bit lower and control the strike zone.
And it's fouled away.
Yeah, you could tell he was ready for another fastball, but the pitcher went to breaking ball. And the hitter just fouls that one off.
The 2-2 pitch. Good eye to lay off the slider there, and he works it to full 3-2 here.
Now on 3-2 as a pitcher, you've got to go with the pitch that you feel most comfortable throwing with.
Good battle here. This will be the seventh pitch coming up. Struck him out, so they work out of the jam as he strands two men in scoring position. Angels strand a couple. They trail it here 3-0. Bottom of the inning now, and that'll bring in the first-year catcher, Zach Collins.
One of the keys to securing a win, they want to keep the pressure on and try to build that lead as much as they can moving into the later innings.
First delivery to him on the way. No offer at that one. It's a called strike. And facing right-handed pitching so far this season, Collins sitting over 330. Nothing to scoff at, clearly.
These are the stats the oppositions look at, being great with runners in scoring position. He has certainly been that, and he's able to slow the moment down.
So far this season, Collins is working with a slugging percentage over 550, so there's no denying he's one of the premier power bats in the league. On around. They really bunch him up on that one as he swings and misses for the first out.
That's a pretty good pitch right there. That fastball on the inner half of the plate. You can see that he just isn't able to get those arms extended, and pretty ugly swing right there.
Stepping in now, Logan Forsythe, as he looks at a fastball but misses off the plate for ball one. The numbers offensively pretty dismal to this point, down in the 170s to start play. Five homers, 13 RBIs. The 1-0.
That's the ball.
Sometimes it can be difficult for a pitcher to facing a guy that's not known to be a big stick in the lineup. Sometimes the toughest thing is to be aggressive and throw strikes.
Too high.
Three balls, no strike.
3-0.
Well, he knows it, but this is the kind of guy you just have to go right after. He's not the biggest threat with the bat, so it's time to challenge him right here.
And this one catches the inside corner for strike one.
Stealing that strike on 3-0 was important, but you don't want to miss over the heart of the plate in this situation. I got to believe he's going to be way more aggressive right here.
Inside with the fastball, and he works the base on ball.
We knew coming into this game that this guy has a tendency to give up a lot of free passes, and history repeats itself as he's already given up two walks here. I'll tell you, effectively wild is a pretty tough thing to be.
So a runner at first with one man gone, and that'll bring up the pitcher, Vince Velasquez. He's set, and the pitch. Now a bunt attempt here. Kenna is there, and he has it for the out.
A batter number two.
So it's back to the top of the order now, and that'll bring in Gene Segura. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. In there, no balls and a strike.
No ball, one strike.
He's been getting lit up all game, and there's a common denominator. He keeps missing right down the middle of the plate. Case in point, that last one.
High in the air into shallow left center. Goodwin is there, makes the catch, and the side is retired. One left for Philadelphia, but they're on top by a count of 3-0. So coming to the plate, Brian Goodwin. He had 8 at-bats in the series. He's collected 3 hits. Ready. Here's the first offering. Swing and a drive to right. There it goes. Gone to lead off the inning. A solo shot here to straightaway right field. Number 11 for him on the season, and the Angels have made it a 3-1 ball game.
Well, if you're going to give up a towering blast to one of the best players in their lineup, it's better to do it with no one on base. It stings, sure, but a solo shot isn't going to be the deciding factor in a game.
So digging in now, Mike Trout was a strikeout victim in his first try.
Yeah, kind of shocked he got blown away with a fastball. You could tell he was late on that one. And we'll see if he tries to cheat to something this evening.
Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. Strike one to start the at-bat. Wind up and the 0-1. Now this one is blasted to left field, and there's no doubt about it. Back to home run here for Mike Trout. 32 now for the season. And the Angels are back within one. It's a 3-2 ball game now.
Another excellent swing right there. That's multiple home runs in the same inning. Watch yourself. You're missing over the heart of the plate.
Hit, making one for two now.
Many guys fall victim to the breaking ball and want to get out in front of it and end up rolling it over to the bullseye. Batter was able to execute, stay inside, keep his hands back, and drive to the other way.
Here's Didi Gregorius. He looks at a fastball that's in there for strike one. 0 for 1 for him here in this one. Comes the 0-1.
One ball, one strike. No, that missed. Two balls, one strike.
Pitch is hit foul off to the left and out of play, so the count goes to 2-2 now. Nobody out, runner on first. Ground ball sent back up the middle. Step on the back for one. On to first, and they get them both.
The batter number one, second baseman, Tommy Rochelle.
Base is empty now after the double play, and that'll give way to the veteran second baseman Tommy La Stella. Here comes the first pitch.
No ball.
You can see this guy's more focused at the plate right now. In that first AB, he went down on strikes.
Bases are empty here with two men out. Too tight with that one. 3-0.
Three balls,
I wouldn't be
strike.
Surprised if he had the green light here. Matter of fact, I know he's got the green light here. He's looking for something set or cut, and he's looking to be down.
There's a swing, and he sends the ball high in the air into left field. Bruce has to retreat to the track, but he has it to retire the shot. So two runs come across here, both coming via the solo home run. We'll head now to the home half of inning number three. It's the Phillies 3 and the Angels 2.
We're back now as the Phillies prepare for their at-bats here in the third inning. And this lineup has been terrific for this club all year. Coming into the day, they are up near the top of the league in home run production. So it's certainly safe to say they're a fun bunch to watch swing the bats. When asked about their success with the long ball, one player told me, "Yeah, home runs are fun and they can change a whole game. So when we get a pitch we can do damage on, you better believe we're looking to launch." Matt, back to you.
Okay, thank you, Heidi.
Way to go.
Digging in for his second at bat, Justin Turner. He'll lead things off here in this one-run contest. Pitch on the way. Hard hit ball to second. And there's one down now.
Now batting, the center fielder, Mark Withenshaw.
Digging in now, Mark Withenshaw. No official at bat for him, but he has scored a run in this one. The pitch. And a bit too high with that one. It's 1-0.
That was a tempting pitch to swing at right there. A big power guy like this really wants something that he can elevate and drive out of the ballpark.
2-0 to the Phillies center fielder.
They obviously circled him before the game that they were not going to let him beat them. Walked him this first time up, and now they're nibbling again.
3-0 now.
To be honest with you, I'm a little bit more afraid of the guy on deck than the guy that's up right now. If I'm on the mound, I want this guy up right now. He's the guy that's got to beat me.
Oh, and this ball is absolutely blasted. High and deep. See you later. So it's a solo shot to dead center. Home run number 5 on the year. And it's given the Phillies a 4-2 lead.
Has absolutely been teeing off on him the last couple of games. Gave up 3 bombs last time out, and he's already given up 2 here in the early going. You want your pitchers to be consistent, but not consistently bad.
The 2-1 home. Bases are empty, 1 man out. Fouled away. Right field and absolutely hammered. Forget about making a play on that ball. It's way out of here. Back to back home run. Solo home run on the bat of Bryce Harper. His second of the game. And just like that, it's now a 5-2 ball game. Watching an impressive power display today. With that one, these two teams have now hit a combined 5 homers in this game.
Matty, this is going to be the home run derby part 2. Zero. 5 bombs already in this one. Yeah, there's a fight in the background for both teams right here. A lot of mislocations right out over the heart of the plate, and neither side is missing.
First time up, he went down looking. Hoskins brings a ton of pop to the plate with him, particularly against right-handed pitching. Some guys don't drive the ball as well when facing a pitcher who throws from the same side that they swing the bat, but that's certainly not the case here.
Yeah, this guy just absolutely hammers right-handed pitching. You know, some guys like the ball in, coming towards them, and that's exactly what the righty-on-righty matchup presents itself. A two-seamer in, a four-seamer that leaks out over the plate, a hanging breaking ball. This guy seems to absolutely hammer those.
Due next is the dangerous Jay Bruce. Still only one out in the inning. Turned on that one and crushed it. Just pulled it a little foul. Swing and a miss as they got him with the slider there, 2 away.
This has not been a weekend to remember for him. He's just been completely lost at the plate, flailing all over the place. Now that's his sixth strikeout of the series. They've really got him figured out.
Into the box now, Jay Bruce. He can't catch up on the fastball at the letters, and it's strike one. He's 0 for 1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far. Into the windup, here comes the 0 and 1.
1 and 1.
Foul tipped at the plate, and that appeared to catch a lot of the home plate umpire in the process. Hope he's all right down there. The 1-2.
2-2.
Soft grounder left side. Scooped up. Off-balance throw gets him. Nice play there as the side is retired. So they get a couple of runs on two hits, no errors, and no one left aboard. Three innings complete. Phillies on top, 5-2. So now it's Mark Pena. So far, 0-for-1 with a flyout.
Number 21, Mark Pena.
First offering on its way. In there, 0-1.
0-1.
A little quick on that swing, and he finds himself behind 0-2. Nothing in two count, and the pitch.
Ball. That's
some action
down.
Out in the bullpen. Couple of right-handers starting to loosen up.
Ball.
This guy uses that two-seamer to set up his other pitches. Two-seamer in, breaking ball away.
And he fouls this one off. Two-two, one more time. It's a wave and a miss. He struck him out.
Well, there's nothing better from a pitcher standpoint than watching that high fastball, now high piece of cheese, swung at and missed. That pitch looks so inviting to hit, but it's awfully tough to put in play.
At the plate, Christian Vasquez. We'll take a look at a slider here that finds the zone for strike one. He'll come into this one with an average way down at 235. Six home runs and 19 driven in. Wind up and the 0-1. Pitch taken several inches below the zone, in fact. Fourth inning here, already a 5-2 score. Ball and two strikes to the Angels catcher. To two balls and two strikes now. Even at two balls and two strikes, here's the pitch.
He got a full count.
Pretty easy pitch to lay off there, 2-2. Not even close to being in the strike zone. He made it easy for the hitter in that one.
Too close for comfort, and he did a good job just to make contact. Swing and a miss got him reaching. Makes the throw to first. Two down.
Now back.
Ready now, Jaime Barria. He'll try to follow up the double in his last at bat with another big hit right here.
Yeah, he jumped all over that first pitch last time up. Interested to see if he has the same approach this AB.
Here's a pop-up now.
Turner
is is under it. He makes the play, and that'll end the inning. Pretty painless half of the inning, all told. To the bottom of inning number four we go. It's the Phillies 5 and the Angels 2. And we're back from Citizens Bank Park in Philadelphia. Let's check in with Heidi Watney.
Matt, I talked with Philadelphia's manager during the break about the Phillies' offensive production to this point. And overall, he's really happy with the at-bats they're putting together. Not only have they already put up a bunch of runs on the board, but they've also made the opposing starter work very hard. His pitch count is high, so it seems they'll be getting into the bullpen sooner rather than later.
Thank you, Heidi. Ready to go in the bottom of the fourth. And next to hit is the catcher, Zach Collins.
Zach Collins.
Infield shifted well to the right. Here's the first pitch.
Ball.
Action now in the Angels bullpen as a left-hander starts to get loose. Into his windup. Here comes the 1-0. Pitch misses in the dirt, and it's 2-0 now.
It's a lot easier to hit when you're putting yourself in good hitters' counts. This guy's done a great job not swinging at pitchers' pitches, and when he's getting the ball in his zone, he's getting the barrel to it. He's been hot lately.
Outside, 3-0 now.
3-0.
Now here it comes. That misses for ball four. It's a leadoff walk that starts at the bottom of the fourth.
Well, that is definitely not the way to start an inning. Now, one thing to give up a walk, but to do it on four pitches is pretty alarming. He looks a little thrown off right now.
So striding forward now, Logan Forsythe. He's hitting .333 in the series, 2-for-6. Pitch coming. Here it is. Fastball well off the plate for a ball. From the belt, kicks and deals. Grounder down the line at third. Forsythe, a 6'1" right-handed swinger and thrower. He was selected in the first round during the 2008 draft.
Yeah, he has turned himself into a really nice ball player. I wouldn't put him on the superstar level, but you know what? They didn't miss with this pick either. You go into high rounds and you carve out a career the way this guy has, nice pick.
Five runs on only four hits and no errors on the ledger for the Phillies to this point. Looks at a fastball inside, so he's in the driver's seat, 3-1.
Got to find a way to get back in the zone. I know you're in danger of losing both to walks, but certainly don't miss over the heart of the plate and have this guy gap one, or even worse, hit a two-run home.
Forsythe with a full 3-2 count. Working for the punch out and the offering. And he lays off there, ball four. So back-to-back walks have him in business here with nobody out.
And this is the kind of thing that's been happening to him all season long. He'll cruise for a while, hitting his spots, and all of a sudden, the wheels come off and he struggles. We'll see if he can recover here.
Dylan Peters answers the call from the pen here in the fourth as they didn't get the outing they were hoping for from the start. Will be his first test out of the bullpen, and it'll be a tough test indeed as he'll face him with two on and nobody out here. From the stretch, trying to give himself up here, but this is foul, so the runners will return. None out, runners at first and second. And now Now a bunt attempt here as he gets this one down. And he'll just scoop this away to make sure it stays foul. So we'll see if they keep the bunt on here with two strikes. Here it comes, 0-2. On sign still on with two strikes as he puts this one down. The second for one on the first. So he comes right out of the bullpen and gets the double play.
Oh, that's the last thing you want to happen when you're trying to bunt a guy in the scoring position. He got it down, but you have to deaden the ball, too. Otherwise, these infielders just eat it up and turn it into a double play.
Two are gone in the Philly fourth, and that'll bring in the middle infielder, Gene Segura. First pitch on its way. And here's a fastball called for strike one.
Here's a moment where you got to be a great teammate. Pick your buddy up who just grounded into a double play. I don't care what it looks like, single, gapper, homer, just get that guy in from third and get your team back in the game.
And he'll step on the bag himself, and the inning is over. Phillies strand one, and it remains 5-2. Welcome back. Heidi Watney standing by as we get set for the top of the fifth.
Matt, I had a chance to discuss the state of the Angels offense with their manager between innings, and he told me the quality of their swings needs to improve as the game moves forward. He said it's been pretty apparent that they're just not finding a lot of hard contact today. There have been a lot of outs on softly hit balls, and while most of the credit for that goes to the opposing pitching, he said it's important for them to continue to make adjustments at the plate. It's games like these where they have to get back to the basics and find a way to generate some offense.
All right, thanks, Heidi. Medina, 6'1" right-hander, will be the one to get the call from the bullpen here. New inning set to get underway. Standing in is the veteran outfielder, Cameron Maven. Here's the first pitch to him. This is in the air out to straightaway center. Withenshaw is right there, and very quickly one gone.
The batter, the left fielder, Brian Goodwin.
Ready once again, Brian Goodwin.
That last at-bat when he went deep, he turned around a pretty good fastball, so I'm kind of thinking this guy's a good fastball hitter, so I might want to move that ball up and down and in and out. Try not to throw right down the middle.
Ball one to start the at bat. Ball and strike.
1-1.
Fouled off. We're in the fifth inning here. 5-2 is our score. And he lays off a pitch outside as they draw even at 2-2. And this is swung on and missed, so it's two up, two down to start the fifth.
Well, you gotta love a live young arm. He's got an electric fastball. If he can learn to harness that and work in his solid secondary stuff, he's going to have a really nice career on the mound. Not everyone is gifted with a fastball like that.
Here's the center fielder, Mike Trout. As he takes a fastball off the plate for a ball, 1-0. He's 1-for-2 in this one. Takes this the other way to right, and that is in there for a two-out base knock. So that's a pair of hits for him now this afternoon as he lines that one sharply into right. And as we take a look at the Angels team leaderboard, you see there he's currently leading the ball club in that category. So now to the plate, Anthony Rendon. in the dirt here, and a nice job keeping it close. It's ball one.
He's going, he's going.
1-0. Pitch inside, the throw. Not in time as he steals second.
Good steal there, and I'll tell you, he is a multi-dimensional player out there. He's got good pop at the plate, and he's shown he's not afraid to use his wheels on the bases either.
To your point, Dan, he did go deep earlier, and now the stolen base here, so he's really having an impact on this game. Knuckle curve and a beauty, 2-1 now. As a look, now the pitch. High and deep down the left field line. And this will wind up a foul ball. Liner toward right center. That gets down. He's got himself a base hit. And the run's going to score from second as it's now a 5-3 ball game.
Yeah, there's a good job of battling right there, D-Ro. Pitcher had the advantage with two outs, two strikes. You're one pitch away, and boy, what a terrific piece of hitting right there.
Yeah, that's a great job right there. Some guys are not afraid to hit with two strikes. They'll take that pitcher deep in the count, feeling comfortable about it. That's the type of hitter this guy is, and he was able to come through.
In now, Didi Gregorius. As the first pitch to him is off the plate for a ball, 1-0. He's 0-for-2 in the ballgame so far. And this one's in the dirt. And the runner will stay put, but the count moves to 2-0. 3 runs, 7 hits. No errors to this point for the Angels. Hit down the line at first, but a foul ball, and it's 2-1 now. From the belt, the pitch, and it's fouled away. So it's a 2-run shot to right center, number 14 on the season, as we are all tied at 5. We've seen these squads go yards 6 times now today. This game has developed into an absolute slugfest, huh, guys?
Dan, they're absolutely knocking the cover off the ball. I'm curious to get your take on this. I didn't find it to be the truth. I didn't mind hitting it.
Thank you.
A lot of guys say they see the ball better during the day.
You know what's funny, D-Lo, is I prefer to pitch in night games as opposed to day games. I always thought it was an advantage to the hitter, and so far that looks like it's the case in this one right here. They must be seeing the ball really well because they're just absolutely smoking the baseball right now.
Zach Eflin, right-hander standing 6'6", will take over pitching duties here. To plate now, Tommy La Stella. Yes, he'll take a look at a slider here that misses for ball one. 0-for-2 for him to this point. The 1-0. Chopped on the ground to first.
Hoskins grabs it cleanly.
And not too shabby out of the pen. Takes just two pitches to get the ground ball, and that ends the inning. With a strike for three in the inning. Two on this two-run home run. On to the bottom of the fifth. All even at five apiece. Digging in to try it again, Justin Turner. It's been an 0-for-2 effort for him to this point. Here's the first pitch to him. And he gets ahead here with the fastball, strike one. Turner swings, and it's a very well-hit ball to left. Trout looks up. Goodbye, home run. So it's a solo shot to dead center. Home run number 16 for him on the year. And this one gives him the lead at 6-5. Of Ruthian proportions, seven combined big flies. You guys remember seeing anything like that in a while?
Yeah, Matt, it's scorching out right now. They always say when the weather gets hot, the ball starts traveling. Dan, what's your point?
Yeah, that's exactly what happens.
You know, come out of spring training, a lot of places it's a little cold, but when it starts to heat up and get hot and humid, it definitely plays right into the hands of the hitters, and they're taking advantage of the conditions today.
The 1-0. Curveball taken low for a ball.
Well, this is a spot you'd like to be in. 2-0, good hitter. Going to turn it loose right here.
Yeah, two balls and a strike. Got a piece. It's 2-2.
Offered at that breaking ball below the zone, and that's a tough one to spit on. But the key is recognizing it coming out of the pitcher's hand earlier, making sure that it goes up before it comes down. More likely to be a hanger when that's the case.
Neither guy willing to give in, and the at-bat will continue. Fastball called, strike three, and there's the first out of the inning.
Next to dig in will be Bryce Harper. His confidence has to be in a really good place right now, having already launched two balls over the fence in this one.
This guy's having a pretty good week so far in one game. His last at bat is second home run of the game. We'll see if they'll pitch him a little bit more carefully in this AP.
One ball, no strikes to count. One out, nobody on. And they won't get him to chase the curveball in the dirt that time, and it's 2-0 now. Up and out over the plate, but a called strike, 2-1.
Gutsy pitch right there. 2-0 changeup for a strike. Good call by the catcher. Great execution by the pitcher.
Into the windup. Here's the 2-1 pitch. A little tall that time. 3-1 now.
Reese Hoskins
is on deck. And he turns this one around high and deep to center field. Back goes Trout. And off the batter's eye for a home run. An impressive shot to dead center field. Dead center, his third home run of the ball game, and they take a 7-5.
Well, talk about having a day.
Sacramento product, Rhys Hoskins. Swing and a drive. This one's deep to right, but it bangs off the out-of-town scoreboard.
Boy, you know, that looked like extra bases right off the bat. This thing turns off the ball. Outfielder does a great job of getting it in quickly and probably does a good job of looking for a single.
Yeah, I'm surprised he's not standing on second base there, but you run the replay back. He was busting it out of the box. It's just a nice job by the defense to hold the base.
There, lefty on lefty matchup, curveball away to a lefty, smart pitch.
He's ready. Here's the 0-1. Hit on the ground to third, to second for one, on to first as they get the double play to get him out of the inning. Around the horn they go, 5-4-3 to end the threat. We're back with more on a Sunday afternoon. Following this. Top half of the sixth about to get started. Here comes the first baseman, Mark Hanna.
Things not looking very good so far in this one, but we're still in the middle innings. They're down by a couple of runs, and this would be the right place and the right time to get something going. The last thing they want to do is to try to come from behind and win this one in the eighth or ninth inning.
The catcher, Christian Vasquez.
At the plate, Christian Vasquez comes into this at bat 0 for 1 in the ballgame. First pitch coming, here it is. And this one's down off the shoe tops, 1-0. A couple of righties starting to loosen now in the bullpen. Bases are empty, one man out. Fastball got him to swing through it. It's 1-1.
This pitcher's bringing it with some high velo. You better get that front foot down early and get ready, or he's going to throw it right by you.
1-2 now as that one's fouled off. Now the pitch. That's a swinging strike three in the dirt. And he makes the throw to first. Vasquez is retired, two down now. David Fletcher will grab a bat and hit for the pitcher here.
Number 10, David Fletcher.
Slider bends into the middle of the strike zone, taken for a strike. And he's a guy looking to break out in a big way. Hasn't been getting the results he or his club have been hoping for. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. And another strike. Good fastball under the hands. It's 0-2.
Yeah, if he's going to pound the zone with this stuff all game, the offense better step up. Somebody's going to have to pull a trigger a little bit earlier in the count.
Out in front of that one, but he stays alive and will do it again on 0-2. Swing and a miss as he chased with two strikes, and that will retire the side. Angels go down 1-2-3. They're down 2-7-5. Noah Ramirez enters to do the pitching in the bottom of the sixth.
Now pitching for the Angels, number 24, Noah
riding in once again, Zach Collins. He'll lead it off as we start the home sixth.
Zach Collins.
First pitch of the at bat on its way. Didn't get on top of the sinker at all, if that's what it was trying to be. It stayed high. changed up on him and dropped it in for a called strike. One and one count. Here's the pitch. And missed the target there with a curveball, and it's 2-1 now. Plays off again, ball three.
3-1.
And, oh, he thought he'd work the walk, but it's a called strike two now. Bottom dropped out on him, and that's a strikeout. And the throw is there to record the first down. Ready for another shot now. Logan Forsythe. A couple of walks for him thus far. Here's the first pitch to him. Here's a curveball that runs outside. It's ball one.
Obviously, the game plan wasn't to let this guy beat you right here. He's already walked twice, and that pitch out of the zone tells me they want nothing to do with him.
Swing and a miss, one strike. Ramirez, a right-hander standing 6'3". He was a fourth-round selection back in 2011.
Hey, nothing has been handed to this guy drafted in the middle rounds, and he has found his way into big leagues. This has turned out to be a really nice pick.
One. Hit pretty well out to deep left field. Looking up is Goodwin, and that one is. Solo shot here to left. Sixth home run on the season for him as they open up an 8-5 lead. We'll get the call here as he'll hit for the pitcher. Get on the ground down the first baseline. Foul ball here, 0-1. Ground out to second. A diving effort here as he gets a glove on it. And not really much of a chance to recover there as he'll reach first on what undoubtedly will be scored as an infield single. And that'll bring up Gene Segura. So he'll wait out a breaking pitch here that finds the zone for strike one. He's got a hit in three at bats to this point. Ball and a strike to the Phillies leadoff man. Swing and a liner. Well, this is pulled in by the shortstop.
Now batting, third baseman, Justin Turner.
So it's a runner at first with two men out. And that'll bring up the third baseman, Justin Turner.
Yeah, this last at bat, he hit a changeup out for a home run. So it'll be interesting this AP to see if they give him a steady diet of fastballs.
Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. On its way, the 0-1 pitch. Big swing and a miss at the fastball, and he's behind in the count 0-2.
Don't expect too many more high fastballs than this one. He is known for his sinker, keeping the ball on the ground.
In the dirt, and now let's see. And he is in there. They couldn't get him at second. And he'll make it into scoring position here with two away, as that'll be scored a wild pitch.
Well, the intent there with that two-strike pitch was obviously to get him to fish for something he couldn't do a whole lot with, but there's the risk that comes with that as well. If you don't execute or your catcher can't handle it very well, you give up three bases.
Tough pitch to lay off there, but he did, and it's even up at 2-2.
So you'd love for him to offer at that one, but the execution was flawless. Nice curveball that starts in the zone and breaks just out. Just a great take by the batter.
Count full, three balls and two strikes. The 3-2 pitch. And
ball
awfully
four, take
close
your
there
base.
On 3-2, but take your base, says Earl Hendricks. It's ball four.
And you can tell by his body language that he's beyond frustrated by that call. He's got to be wondering what he's got to do, but the last thing he needs to do is to let it get under his skin. That will only make things worse.
Standing in, Mark Withenshaw. We'll see if he can come through in a clutch spot here. Two on, two out here in inning number six.
Go, Philly.
He's set. Here it comes. Now a breaking ball, but it's low.
One ball, no strike.
The 1-0 misses for the second ball.
That's the ball.
Has to be a challenge pitch coming up here. He probably doesn't want to flirt with loading the bases.
Two down, runners at first and second. Too far out in front that time. You can't keep it fair. 2-1. Looking to minimize the damage here.
This is one of those innings where nothing comes easy. He's thrown a bunch of pitches, and this AB hasn't been any different. Definitely laboring at the moment.
Now the payoff pitch home. Fouled away. Two men are on with two men out. And he
ball
misses
four.
Again. Ball four. And that's back-to-back guys now that have reached base field base on ball.
Right about now, the manager's questioning his decision to bring this guy in. If you can't trust a reliever to throw strikes, you can't trust him at all. We'll see if he comes to get him sooner than later.
Bryce Harper stride in again as he looks to join a very elite list. We take you back to earlier. This was home run number three in the ballgame as he'll try and join just a select few with four home runs in a single game. Here comes the first pitch.
This guy loves to drop the head on those pitches down and in. I'm shocked he went in there, but he's able to jump ahead and get away with it.
Two out, bases loaded. Sinker.
No, that hit. That's
one
a ball.
Strike.
He's already walked two in this inning already. This guy just can't seem to find the strike zone.
As this pitch misses, it's 2-1.
Well, things are bad enough as it is right now. One run in, base is juiced, and now he's fallen behind the count. You can bet the guy at the plate is thinking about making this a five-run inning in a hurry.
Sinker misses there, and now he's in trouble. 3-1.
Three balls, one
strike. This is a spot you like to be in as a good hitter. Runners in scoring position and count leverage in your favor.
Bases are loaded here. Two down. There's the good fastball, and he can't catch up. 3-2.
It's not easy to get your barrel to a pitch that high. That can be an effective location as long as he keeps it above the letters.
Into the corner and slicing foul. Misses. Ball four. A run will come in to score.
And it's times like these that a pitcher feels awfully lonely. I can see why he didn't want to be too aggressive. Last thing he wants to do is give up a grand slam to a dangerous hitter, but walking in a run is painful too, and here he is again still with the bases loaded.
Digging in once again, Reese Hoskins. Eighth batter of the inning now with the bases loaded and two away. Hoping to limit the damage, here's the pitch. First pitch, curveball, swung on and missed, strike one.
After the walk and with runners on the bags, he couldn't afford to fall behind here. Nice job of jumping ahead with strike one.
Count set and the 0-1. Curveball bounces here, but a good job behind the plate to keep it at arm's length.
Nice.
Ball and two strikes.
A strike away now from getting out of this mess. Sometimes pitching is all about minimizing, right? So keeping it to two runs across in the inning would be huge.
Two out, bases loaded. Ground ball right side. There is LaStella. Throw on to first, and an important pitch there as they get out of the inning before things explode. So they do strike for two, but it could have been much worse as they strand the bases loaded. We're through six full. It's the Phillies 9 and the Halos 5. Mike Morin is on to pitch from the bullpen now to start inning number 7.
Number 28, Mike Morin.
Now with the play, Cameron Maven. It was a flyout for him in his last trip.
It doesn't look very promising so far in this one as we move into the later innings. Down by a bundle, it's time to get some base runners and hopefully a long ball to get them back into this one.
Too high that time with the inning's first pitch. It's ball one. Pitch taken several inches below the zone, in fact. And he fouls this one off. Tried to crush that ball and now perhaps needs to shorten up with two strikes. He's set. Here's the 2-2. Here's a shot to left field and deep. Look at this. And out of here. And I mean by plenty. That ball was crushed. A solo shot here for Cameron Maben. Home run number 15 for him thus far. And just like that, it's down to a 3-run ball game. Into the box, Brian Goodwin. And on the first pitch, he grounds foul. He's working on a 1-for-2 game so far. Ready with the 0-1. Breaking ball that time that misses out of the zone. No outs, nobody on. Now a drive out to left center field. Through first and hustling for second. And they'll keep it going here as he's in with a double.
You think they'd stop pitching to this guy by now? He's been torching them all weekend, and he stays hot here with another extra base hit. They'll be happy when this series is over, so they don't have to deal with this dude anymore.
At the plate now, Mike Trout. Nope. The first pitch misses high and inside for ball one. So far, 2-for-3 in this one. Minnesota born ball player. He was a 13th round pick during the first year player draft of 2012.
I know this guy wouldn't go into the category of superstar, but to grind out the career he has being drafted where he was, my hat's off.
All even now, 2-2. No one out with a runner at second. Swung on, and this ball is absolutely crushed. Forget about it. And this ball is gone. No chance to make a play on that one. A two-run shot that time for Mike Trout. His second home run of the game, as it's now a one-run ball game. Take over with nobody out in inning number 7.
Number 25, Jorge Rodriguez. The third baseman, number 6.
At the plate, Anthony Rendon. Oh, yeah. As he takes a cold strike at the knees, it's 0-1. Here it comes. Fouled off. Base is empty here with nobody out. Here's a high pop-up. There to make the catch is Hoskins, and that's the first out of the inning.
Now back. Shortstop. Beatty.
So one away now for the Angels in the 7th. And here's the left-handed hitting shortstop Didi Gregorius now.
Yeah, that last at-bat, Danny, he turned that fastball around. He didn't hit it a ton. He didn't hit it a country mile. But, hey, listen, a home run is a home run.
And that misses inside 1-0.
One ball, no strike.
That's wide, 2-0. After the foul ball there. Still only one out in the inning. And it's fouled away. Full count now, 3-2.
When you're playing close games like this, base runners mean everything, so he can ill afford to start giving away free passes.
Now the 3-2 pitch. A swing and a drive hit well out to right field. Back goes Harper. On the warning track, he makes the catch.
The batter number 9, second baseman, Tommy LaStella.
Stepping in, Tommy LaStella. He was a ground out victim last time up. First offering on its way.
Yeah. 0-1.
Oh and one, here it comes.
Strike two.
Here's strike two as it catches the outside corner.
Your idea of working the count goes out the window. You're frustrated right now. Down 0-2. Gotta find a way to grind.
Now a cutter down and on to shoe tops as he hops out of the way.
One ball.
Great pitch right there on 0-2. Purpose pitch, right? Running that ball in off the plate. Now that opens up that whole strike zone, and you're not quite as comfortable as a hitter.
Two out, nobody on. Breaking ball there is down. Good job of laying off. It's back to 2-2.
Pretty good breaking ball to lay off of right there. If I'm pitching, I might think this guy might be sitting on something off speed.
Cutter in, it doesn't make it back. 3-2.
Boy, went from being in the driver's seat to now being in some trouble. Had the count 0-2, started nipping at the corners, and next thing you know, this count stands at 3-2.
Now the payoff pitch home. Swing and a line drive. A leaping try, but it's out of his reach and into the outfield.
It's so frustrating as a pitcher. You make a quality pitch on the inside of the plate right there. Trying to bust him in the air, he fights it off the other way.
Yeah, you tip your hat to the pitcher right there. He executed his pitch, but nice job by the offensive player. Fighting. Doesn't matter what it looks like. He knocks him out.
Victor Darius. And so we're here with a runner at first and two down in the inning. Into the box now, Mark Canna. He'll look at a fastball in there on the outer half. It's 0-1.
Hey, I know the tying runs at first right here, but if the pitcher on the mound executes, keeps the ball in play, I think good things are going to happen.
Here's the 0-1. Swings through it for strike number 2. Protecting on 0-2, so we'll do it again. Two out with the man at first. And oh, look out! Up and in and nearly took his head off.
Not sure if that was a purpose pitch or not, but I liked it. As a pitcher, sometimes you've got to be willing to back the guy off the plate by running something hard inside. You can't just let guys be comfortable standing in the batter's box against him.
Fouled away. The next 1-2 pitch. And he strikes him out here, so he's able to stop the bleeding a bit as the side is retired. Took three runs on 4 hits, no errors, and a man left on. We'll move on now to the bottom half of the 7th. Get up and stretch. It's the Phillies 9 and the Angels 8. Now the skipper's on his way out toward the home plate area, and I believe that means we're going to have a double switch here. Ty Buttrick is in out of the bullpen now as he'll be inserted into the number 6 spot following the double switch. Jamie Jones will also come on now as he'll move into the pitcher's number nine hole in the order here on that double switch. Last half of the seventh here, coming forward the veteran outfielder, Jake Bruce.
So what here?
From the stretch. Pitch on the way. They really bunch him up on that one as he swings and misses for the first out.
This is the kind of the bat where your hitting coach grabs you on the way back to the dugout to have a little chat about your approach. Not a lot of positives to draw from that at bat when you take two strikes and then you chase one out of the zone to go down on only three pitches.
Stepping in now, Zach Collins. As he'll take a changeup here for strike one. It's a high fly ball headed for the left field corner. If it stays fair, it's gone. And he pushed it just a bit too much and wind up a foul ball. Fastball straightens him up a bit. One and two now.
Pretty good pitch right there. Fastball in off the plate. One of the things you want to do as a pitcher, try to stand those hitters up.
Look out. That one almost got away from him. Two and two now. Lofted in the air out toward right center. Trout has a read on it. He's got it, and there are two down now.
Now back, second baseman, Logan Forsythe.
Logan Forsythe will stand in yet again as we flash you back to the middle inning. This was a turning point here. A solo home run that was really one of the key at-bats of the ballgame to this point. First delivery to him on the way.
Ball.
And a ball 1-0.
1-0.
Hit out towards second. And they are not going to get him at first. He's aboard easily.
And hey, that's great hustle right there out of the box. Not everybody's getting it right out of the chute from step one, but I have to ask you, Dan. And you can read that right off the bat as a pitcher. You can read the angle. You know that that ball is going to be hit on the ground. You're thinking deep down inside, okay, there's a quick out. It just wasn't meant to be.
First pitcher misses wide, 1-0. He'll enter play here at 293. Eight home runs and 30 RBIs. Ready. Here's the 1-0 down the third baseline. And he comes back with a fastball. 1-2 now.
Sometimes you can get away with a pitch in that location when you're running it up there that hard, but not consistently. You still have to work the edges of the zone most of the time.
Swing and a miss as he chases one out of the zone for the third strike, and that's the third out of the inning. One left for Philadelphia. They lead it 9-8. Feet been summoned from the bullpen as he'll do so to start the eighth. Christian Vasquez.
This thing's far from over, even though we're moving into the back end of this game. Only down by one. All they need to do is get this leadoff guy, and they're an extra base hit away from tying this thing up.
Here comes the first pitch. A changeup there to start him, but it drops a little low for ball one. A runner stands 6-2 and throws from the right side. He's in his fourth season as a major league player. Hardy on that swing as it's well wide of first. Lays off a slider that time. 2-1. Now action in the bullpen as their closer starts to get loose out there. Deal. Here's the 2-1.
Ball 3-1.
Great situation right here. Leading off the inning, you've got to find a way to get on base any way possible. But I don't like to take the aggression away from hitters. If it's in your zone, I want you swinging.
And there's a called strike at the knees. He was hoping for a base on balls there, but it's a full count now. 3-2. And he struck out again. That's the third time he's gone down on strikes in this one. Time now for a starter comparison. And that tells the story. As you can see, neither guy able to get past five innings. Stepping up now, Jamie Jones. And he's getting his first plate appearance here in the eighth after entering off the bench just a little bit ago. Now the pitch. Swing and a miss that time. It's 0-1.
That's just too much velocity upstairs to get good wood on it. It's going to have to lower his sights.
Here's the 0-1 pitch.
Two.
Hey, it looks like this guy's going to work in the upper part of the strike zone. It'll be interesting to see if this lineup can adjust to the way he pitches.
Too much bite on the breaking ball that time as it's well off the outside.
Classic strikeout pitch right there on 0-2. It's the one we know he loves going to, but great recognition to lay off in that spot.
And this is sent on the ground out to Segura at short. In time to first, and there are two away.
Now batting, Mike Gilbert, Cameron Maybe.
Riding in, Cameron Maybin. Two hits in four attempts to this point.
Yeah, now this guy flexed his muscles in that last at bat. We heard that he has good power. That last bomb had to go well over 400 feet. He hit it a long way.
0-1 the count. Tying run at the plate, the 0-1. Grounded down the third baseline. But this will wind up a foul ball, strike two.
You can definitely tell with that foul off right there that he's picking up spin on this pitcher's off-speed stuff. Maybe expect a fastball on this next one.
Taken in by Forsythe. And the off-balance throw is right there for the third out. High degree of difficulty on that one as his side is retired. Ready to go for the last half of the inning. Ready to bring in Gene Segura.
Not your job. Gene.
Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. Yeah. Here it comes. Yeah. slider. Ooh, thought he had him, but it's 1-2.
That was a nasty sweeping slider right there. If he was able to just catch the back door a little bit, he would have picked up that backwards K.
The 1-2. Pop high in the air.
Kenna
is there for it. One down.
Now batter, the third baseman, Justin Turner.
At the plate, Justin Turner. He went deep back in the fifth. First delivery to him on the way. And a high strike to begin the at bat. It's 0-1. Change up in on the hands that evens it at 1-1. And he lays off for a ball, 2-1. Took a good cut that time. It comes up empty, 2-2. One out, nobody on. Pitch is popped up. Rendon is in his tracks now. Two gone.
The center fielder, number 24, Mark Withenshaw.
Standing in, Mark Withenshaw. Comes the first pitch.
Hey, great job pounding the zone, strike one. When you got a great hitter in the box, got to get ahead. Count leverage is a must.
Bases are empty here with two men out. In front of the changeup, and he can't keep it fair. Two strikes on him now. Quick strikes, and now the 0-2.
One, two.
Now a fastball here that'll wisely lay off, and it's 1-2. And a good fastball swung and missed for strike three, and the inning is over. Three up, three down for Philadelphia. They lead it 9-8. David Robertson comes on from the pen, hoping to finish this one off here in the top of the ninth. Brian Goodwin striding again, and before he takes his cuts here, let's flash you back to the third inning. This was just a solo shot, but it definitely helped get this offense going. And nothing pitch. That's off we go in the ninth as the first pitch misses for ball one. A 2-0 count to the Angels left fielder.
You'll hear me say this time after time up here in the booth. You fight so hard to get into these counts. 1-0, 2-0, 3-1. They don't happen often. This is a huge spot. Count leverage. Look for him to get loose on the fastball.
3-0 to him now. And now pitch on the way. Yeah. lays off ball four. So now the potential time run here is aboard late in the game.
Well, there's only a one-run cushion to play with, so he's got to be upset after he walked the leadoff man here. Go-ahead run comes to the plate, and there are no outs. This could be a very interesting inning.
Mike Trout will get another shot at it here as we take you back to inning number 7. This was his second home run of the ballgame, as he'd like nothing more than to make it 3 right here.
See if they can get the final out and wrap this thing up.
So the Angels down to their final out now, and that'll bring up Anthony Rendon. From the stretch, here's the pitch. Taken, and that one catches the bottom part of the strike zone. Hit sharply on the ground to second, and that is through into right field for a single.
Now that shortstop.
Plate now,
Didi Gregorius.
No, first pitch out. Misses to him. It's ball one. He'll be looking for something he could drive into the gap and drive home that tying run from first. Now 1-0. Angels down to their last strike. Shoots this one to first. That gets down. He's got himself a base hit. So now they'll have two men in scoring position following the two-out double.
As the pitching coach heads out for the mound, I think this is probably just a case of giving your guy a chance to catch his breath, pump him up a little bit, let him know that he's got it under control.
Shohei Ohtani will be called upon here to hit with the game on the line.
Number 17, Shohei Ohtani.
Trying to hold the lead. Here's the delivery.
Great take right there. You knew the pitcher was going to try and expand the zone 0-2 in a big spot. And he was able to spit on that one. Hopefully get something in the heart of the plate this pitch.
Here's the 1-2. Struck him out. So a great job of working out a certain danger. He's ran the possible tying and winning runs on base. And the ball game is over.
Yeah, that's the way you want to finish a three-game home series. Breaking out the Bruins and sweeping the other guys right out of there.
The close win 9-8 at the end of the game in this one. The Phillies, with their 50th team win, tops in the division. Zach Eflin earns the victory out of the bullpen, his fifth. David Robertson earns the save out of the bullpen, his tenth. So that just about does it for Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, and our entire crew. I'm Matt Baskers, and you've been watching MLB The Show. For more, make your way over to theshownation.com.